things that we do in our states that engage our attention that we would want to leave our states. But there are other issues that are national in outlook that you want to focus on, and that you have the sympathy of the president, that the president will want to consult the governors and have a chat with them on those issues. And we come. And one of them is agriculture, because we believe that the more farms you create, you achieve two things. You create employment, you food security is also assured. And I think that we're looking at all that.
Mm. Talking about agriculture, let's talk about River State now. The Songhai Farm. When some people saw it, that the state government could be undertaking that kind of a large-scale agricultural enterprise. I think the other state that is also doing something close to that is Odo, where they also have something close to like a school to farm agriculture. Now, what is the magic? And how, I don't know whether you have patents on it, whether it's also an idea that you could also talk about publicly, at least for the benefit of other states who will want to do something like that, to first of all address the question of unemployment and then address the issue of food sufficiency.
We've gone beyond Songhai Farm and River State. We're trying to establish a multi-crop farm.
Multi-crop?
In River State, in a chip that has capacity for 3,000 hectares of land with 300 homes in the farm. The farmers will live there, and it's a total of $146 million. We have partners coming from Israel. We are bringing $100 million. They are bringing $46 million. Oh, $42 million. And it will have primary cropping and then agro-processing. So we are looking at cocoa, we are looking at maybe pineapple and other crops, about two or more crops that we'll have. Out of this 3,000, that will be the commercial element of the farm. Behind this, we have another 2,000 to 3,000 hectares, which will be assigned to those who live in the farm. Those who live in the farm will have 300 homes. So they will have their own hectares of farmland that they will farm and use to pay the rent of the property they're occupying. There'll be school for their children. There'll be health center for themselves and their children. Then they will participate in the proper commercial farm. So now, on their side, they will employ people to farm on their own land. Then they will be working on the commercial farm. So they are generating their own income from which they pay for the infrastructure that we are putting in place. While they also...
They're also indirectly employers of labor.
That's another farm that we have. The next one is the banana farm, 2,000 hectares of banana farm in the Gunland, which the Mexicans have just arrived.